Hi, all. Myself, Angel Sebastian, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Rajagiri School of Engineering and Technology. This session deals with traffic flow theory fundamentals. It is a topic in sixth module of the course CE366, Traffic Engineering and Management, which comes under APJ Abdul Kalam Technological University. These are the contents included in this presentation. Scope of traffic flow theory. Then we will see some basic definitions, fundamental equation, then the basic diagram of traffic flow. Introduction. Traffic flow theory is defined as the mathematical study of the movement of vehicles over road network. Traffic flow studies are of great importance to a traffic engineer as it provides him with a knowledge of vehicular traffic, leading to improved techniques for control, regulation, and management of traffic. It includes relation between speed, flow, and concentration. Concentration is also known as density. Various approaches to frame relationship includes car following theory, hydrodynamic analogy, etc. Different measures of speed are used in traffic flow analysis, like spot speed, time mean speed, and space mean speed. An important thing next is the knowledge of probability and statistics in mathematics are needed for the study of congestion, delay, queuing, headway, gap between vehicles, etc. These are some of the basic definitions of traffic flow theory. First one is speed. Speed is rate of movement of vehicular traffic. Its unit is kilometer per hour. Next is flow. Number of vehicles passing a specified point. Unit is expressed as vehicle per hour. Next is density. Density of vehicle, that is number of vehicles present in a specified length of road at an instant. Its unit is vehicle per kilometer. Here you can see the equation to find density of vehicles in 1 kilometer stretch of road. K is equal to 1000 by S, where S is the space headway. Space headway means distance between fronts of successive vehicles. Here in this figure, you can see vehicle 1 and vehicle 2 are separated by a distance of 100 meter. Using this equation, we can find the number of vehicles present in 1 kilometer stretch of road if all the vehicles are separated by 100 meters. Here, 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. That 1000 comes in the numerator divided by space headway equal to 100 meter. We'll get K equal to 10 vehicles in 1000 meter. That is 10 vehicle per kilometer. In this figure, you can see I have marked only 200 meter and vehicle 1 and vehicle 2 are coming inside this 200 meter. Vehicle 3 is outside that 200 meter. So in this case, if only 200 meter is considered, then density is equal to 200 by 100 equal to 2. 1 and 2. Vehicle 1 and vehicle 2 are there in this 200 meter. So we have seen the space headway as distance between fronts of successive vehicles. Next is time headway, that is time interval between passage of fronts of successive vehicles at a specified point in a road. Its unit is in seconds. That is, The time at which a vehicle's front portion touching a particular point is noted. Then, the time at which the front portion of next vehicle touching the same point is noted. The interval between these two times gives the time headway, and its unit is in seconds. Next is time mean speed and space mean speed. They are the average values of some speed measurements. The mathematical equations to find time mean speed and space mean speed separately can be understood from this question. Here, the speeds of 25 cars are given, and the number of cars and their speeds are given separately. We can substitute in this equation to get the values for time mean speed and space mean speed. Here another simple question to find time mean speed and space mean speed. In the question, the sport speeds of five different vehicles are given. Sport speed means the instantaneous speed of a vehicle at a specified location, a specified point in a road. That five speeds are given, so n will be 5. Can substitute in this simple equation to get the values separately. And another equation given here is a relation connecting time mean speed and space mean speed. Now we will see the relationship between variables. Variables are the fundamental parameters of traffic flow. They are speed, flow, and density. The space mean speed, flow, and density are related by the equation Vs is equal to Q by K. That is, space mean speed is equal to flow by density. Or we can write this equation as Q is equal to KV. Also, we can substitute the non-equation K is equal to 1000 by S in this equation to get another form, that is Vs is equal to Q into S by 1000, where S is the space headway. Next, space and time headway relation is also given as S equal to H into Vs into 1000 by 3600. So, we have seen the equation connecting three variables. Now, we will see the diagram showing the relation between each of these two parameters on a given stretch of road. Each parameters separately means the curve showing relation between density and flow, another curve showing relation between flow and speed, and another curve showing relation between density and speed. Then, these three curves are connected to get a fundamental diagram of traffic flow. Before going in detail to each three curves, let's understand the meaning of jamming concentration. Concentration is another word for density. As its name indicates, the condition is jamming condition in the road. That is, all vehicles are closely packed in the road. It can be explained with the help of some values. In the right side, it is given. Consider one lane of a 1 kilometer road section with only 5 meter long cars. If cars are closely packed one behind the other, then S also will be 5 meter. The meaning is that each car is having a length of 5 meter. If they are closely packed, then the distance between the front portion of successive vehicle will be 5 meter. That 5 meter is equal to S. The equation for density, that is K is equal to 1000 by S, is known. Here, in the jamming condition, the length of the vehicle will be same as the S value. So, KJ can be found using 1000 meter divided by 5 meter. It is equal to 200 vehicles.
per kilometer per lane. In this case, 200 vehicles are closely packed in 1 kilometer length of a road in one lane. That is jamming condition of that road. The first curve is density flow curve. As its name indicates, this is the curve connecting density and the corresponding flow on a given stretch of road. Here in this figure, I have marked 1, 2 and 3. 1 is the case when density is 0. Here I have written, when K is 0, flow will also be 0. Since there is no vehicle on the road, so the point 1 is having K value and Q value as 0. Next, the point 2. When number of vehicles gradually increases, K and Q also increases and Q reaches at a maximum value. The maximum Q that can be accommodated in a road is the capacity of road. When number of vehicle exceeds this capacity of road, that is when more and more vehicles are added, it reaches a situation where vehicles cannot move. This is referred to as the jam density. During jam density, the flow of vehicles will be zero. The same density flow curve with one more feature is shown here, that is slope. Slope of line joining any two points in flow density curve. Here I have marked one. The point 1 is marked as O and another point A is also marked. The slope of line joining O and point A is the space mean speed for the traffic condition with KA and QA. We have the basic equation. Speed is equal to flow by density. The same here also. VA is equal to QA by KA. Then OB is marked in the figure. That is the tangent at the starting point. That is mean free speed VSF. Mean free speed, that is free flow condition. That is the speed which can be adopted by a driver when there are no other interferences. The second curve, flow speed curve. That is the diagram showing relation between flow of vehicles and the corresponding speed on a given stretch of road. Here I have marked 3, 2 and 1. First one, I will explain 3. That is, flow is 0 case. Flow is 0 means any single vehicle entering to that road can take free speed. Same thing we have discussed while studying level of service. So the condition is similar clue to LOS A. Hence, speed is equal to mean free speed denoted by VSF. Second point, volume of vehicles increased from 0 and flow reached a maximum value, that is capacity of the road. When the number of vehicles exceeds that capacity, then the speed of vehicle decreases and reaches a point 1, that is there are too many vehicles so that they cannot move. So flow and speed will be 0. Next, the third curve, density speed curve. That is the diagram showing relation between density and the corresponding speed of vehicles in a given stretch of road. This red line is the shape of the curve. The exact shape depends on the actual condition of traffic. It may take parabolic shapes also. Here, in all the diagrams, we are marking the independent parameter in the x-axis and the dependent parameter in the y-axis. Here, the independent parameter we are taking as density k. When k is approximately equal to 0, then that is free flow condition, that is level of service A. In that case, Vs will be equal to Vsf. That is marked here. That is, at k equal to 0, V is the maximum value, that is Vsf. When k is equal to kj, that is jamming condition, that time no movement of vehicles, so Vs reduces to 0.
This is our same curve, kv curve, seen in the last slide. We know two points of this curve. In the x-axis, kj is there. In the y-axis, Vsf is there. The equation of a line is typically written as y equal to mx plus b, where m is the slope and b is the y-intercept. Here, this is a falling curve, so the slope is negative, so minus Vsf by kj. And we can frame the equation of our kv curve like this. In the previous slide, we have seen Greenshield's linear relationship. The person Greenshield made the assumption that under uninterrupted flow conditions, speed and density are linearly related. This relationship is expressed as a graph in the previous slide, and mathematically it can be written as this equation 1. Now, this equation 1 can be written in different forms by substituting our basic equation of traffic flow, that is Q equal to KV. So substituting the value of Vs equal to Q by K in equation 1, we will get the equation 2 here. Next, similarly, putting the equation K equal to Q by Vs, writing this equation in terms of Q by Vs will give an equation 3. From Greenshield's linear equation, that is equation 1, we could frame two new relationships between Q, K and V as equations 2 and 3. This provides an avenue for finding density and velocity at which flow is maximized. Here we can see the steps. Differentiating equation 2 with respect to K and equating to 0, K at Q max can be obtained. This is mathematics, that is dQ by dK is found and it is equated to 0. Then rearranging them to get K max as kj by 2. This indicates that the maximum flow occurs when the density is half of the jamming density. We have already seen this kq curve. Here the k max value, that is kj by 2, is marked corresponding to Q max. Similar steps are used here to get Vs max at Q max. Here equation 3 is used. Differentiating 3 with respect to Vs and equating to 0, we get Vs at Q max. These are the steps. dQ by dVs is taken here, differentiated with respect to Vs and equated to 0, rearranged, and we got Vs max as Vsf by 2. This indicates that the maximum flow occurs when traffic is flowing at half of the free flow speed. Thus, we can show the Vsf by 2 value corresponding to Q max in our Q V curve. Thus, at Q max, we got K max equal to Kj by 2 and Vs max is equal to Vsf by 2. It means that when maximum flow of vehicles occur at a road section, there the density of vehicles will be half of jamming concentration. And those vehicles have speed value as half of the free flow speed. Putting this Kmax value and Vsmax value in our basic equation Q is equal to Kv, we can find the value of Qmax as Kj into Vsf by 4 like this. Till now, we have seen our three curves separately, that is our Kv curve, Qv curve, and KQ curve separately. Now, from the previous slide, we could arrive at a conclusion that at Qmax, we have Kmax value is equal to Kj by 2 and Vsmax value equal to Vsf by 2. So, this can be combinedly shown in our three curves like this. See the bottom graph, there Qmax is shown. The density value in x-axis is also given. The density value corresponding to Qmax we have found as Kj by 2 is shown. A red line is drawn upwards. There it means Kv curve. There the point at which that red line meets the Kv curve, that value in the y-axis is Vsf by 2. Then a horizontal red line is shown towards the Qv curve. There Vsf by 2 value is shown, and also that Vsf by 2 value is corresponding to the Qmax value. We have found the Qmax value as Kg into Vsf by 4. That's also shown here. This is speed flow density relationship of Green-Shields linear model. In this presentation, we have gone through different graphs. Actually, there are only three graphs. That is, our three curves connecting speed flow, speed density, and flow density. I have included more than one time to explain different concepts. Here, the three graphs are combined together like this. It is known as fundamental diagram of traffic flow. The combined diagram showing relationship between speed flow, speed density, and flow density are called the fundamental diagrams of traffic flow. In the previous slide, we have shown the value of K and V corresponding to Q max. Similarly, K and V values for any Q value other than Q max can also be shown like the red line in this figure. Thank you all for the patience for hearing me.